As a cancer survivor myself, like, I don't tell my family things. It's things that would worry them. It's things I know would make them concerned. I also don't tell my friends things because it goes to such a level that, like, they can only handle so much of it before they literally have to go to their next meeting. Yeah. So there's so much I don't tell people. But when I sit down with somebody who has cancer, literally if it's the first time I sit down with them, this is my opportunity to, like, share everything. You know,
right,
I don't care where he's from, where he's born, where what cancer he has. He feels the same way with me, where we can literally, like, just vomit up all of the details of our cancers with each other because we're in the same boat. And so what happens is that you get these 25 people all in one room. Everybody feels that immediately.
Yeah.
And you can bring a partner. It could be a spouse, best friend, sibling, whatever. But a lot of them choose not to because they've kind of been hiding some portions of their cancer.
Yeah.
Even from their closest
just
friend.
Just anger. Like, I think it's just everything. Yeah. Resentment. Like, you can finally go, okay, how are you dealing with this? Because I hate everybody right now. I hate everybody. Or I love everybody or whatever
and,
it might
and
be.
And everybody at this place is all across the board.
Yeah.
But it's okay for me to say I hate cancer and to have the person next to me say I love cancer. I'm not upset. Like, because we both have cancer. We both have this in common.
Yeah.
So the interesting thing is that these people just gather around each other. And I remember one of the first nights we were all there, none of these people, not one of them, knew another person there. And that first night where we weren't supposed to talk about cancer, but of course after dinner everybody started talking about it. Mm-hmm. We were sitting in the backyard around this great bonfire, sharing just crazy stories about everybody. Mm-hmm. And we're laughing and we're crying. And I've never seen a group of people who do not know each other at all mesh together so quickly.
Mm-hmm.
And so just perfectly to where they are still talking to each other today. And it's this evidence that when you meet somebody who's going through what you're going through, whether or not you feel the same way about hatred towards it or love towards it, like, you have something.
It's the same conversation we had about God, right?
Yeah,
so it's
it's
different and it's all true and real. It's all encompassing.
Yeah.
But you feel a connection through even just that commonality of like, okay, we believe in some type of God.
Yeah, and we're never both going to figure it out. So let's just chat. Let's just see what we can toss out there. Yeah.